Yeah, hello everyone, I'm Stefan from Gnosis, and today I will talk about conditional tokens, or conditional assets, and, okay, I have to send here. So, what are conditional tokens? What can we do with conditional tokens? Just to give some examples, yeah, so today we have stock market, we have prices for stock, and there are futures on stock. And you can see there are short positions on stock. There's, for example, a short position on Tesla, and you can see how big this short position is. But you don't know exactly why people are shorting Tesla. And now with conditional tokens, we allow to short or go long or do investments in general under certain conditions. So for example, for Tesla, there could be now a market where you can short Tesla under the condition that Elon Musk will step down, or that Tesla will not ramp up their Model 3 production. And then you could see what the price difference is between the Tesla stock under the condition that those events happen or not. And this can create clear signals how a company should behave. And to give some more examples, so we could also create such conditional assets within the Ethereum ecosystem. We could create, for example, conditional assets on EIPs. We could signal what is the change of the ETH price under the condition that an EIP is implemented, or what is the change of the Ethereum transaction fees under the condition that a certain EIP is implemented. And those conditional assets, they could give very clear signals to the community, to shareholders, how decisions should be done. Yeah. So how can those be created within smart contracts? Let's first recap how actually prediction markets work before we talk about conditional prediction markets. So a prediction market is actually quite simple. Let's go back to this example. Will Elon Musk step down until the end of 2019? What you essentially do is you have a smart contract. You send in one DAI, and the smart contract will issue you one ERC20 token for each possible outcome. In this case, yes or no. And you keep the token that you believe is the factual, is representing the factual outcome in the end. Let's say you believe that yes, Elon Musk will step down, then you keep the yes token and you will sell the no token on the market. At some point, the oracle will decide which outcome is the factual outcome. Let's say in this case, yes, Elon Musk stepped down, then the oracle will provide this information to the smart contract. And then this smart contract will allow to redeem this one DAI that the user initially put in for sending the yes outcome token back to the smart contract. So essentially, the no token that was sold by the user is his profit. And that's already how all prediction markets work, no matter if they're implemented with Augur or Gnosis or any other system. So based on this, how can we create a conditional prediction market? It's actually also quite straightforward. So what we have now is we have two prediction markets, let's say. We want to actually predict if the Tesla stock is above $300 at the end of 2019 or below under the condition that Elon Musk was stepping down, yes or no. So what we essentially do is we create here actually three markets. Yeah, the first market is just a prediction market on if Elon Musk will step down, yes, no. And then we're using the yes and the no token as collateral in the other markets, yeah, in the second market, which is, will Tesla stock be above $300, yes or no? So the reason why this is a conditional market is because the tokens, the yes, oh, can I use here? I think I can move the mouse, yeah. So the yes token here that we're using as collateral in the second market, this only has value under the assumption that Elon Musk will actually step down. If Elon Musk doesn't step down, then this token has no value, so all trading activity here also is meaningless. So if you're looking at this, and if you believe, or if we understand that those here are all smart contracts, those here are basically token contracts, ERC20 token contracts, then we can already see that just in order to create this one conditional market, we are creating quite a few ERC20 tokens. So it's quite gas costly and quite inefficient in terms of representing this in a smart contract. There's also another issue, which is ambiguity. So, I guess I have to do this, yeah. So, we just created a market where we say Tesla stock will be above $300 under the condition that Elon Musk will step down. We could also create vice versa, a market where we say, will Tesla stock be, will Elon Musk step down under the condition that Tesla stock will be above or below $300. So we basically just swap both markets, and then we would have those here, those two markets where we have Q1 under condition Q2 or Q2 under condition Q1, and we create in the end those ERC20 tokens here, and actually those are representing the same, but they are not fungible because they're different ERC20 tokens. So we create here a layer of inefficiency which is just not necessary. And that's why we invented a new prediction market framework, which essentially is implementing ERC1155 token. So it's a new EIP for multi-token, for multi-token standards. So you have all tokens in one contract, and you can identify tokens with an identifier. And this identifier now is created by us by representing what the user is actually holding. So by the positions that the user is holding in this market. So, and this is what we call positions. Yeah? So a position is what the user, this is a combination of the collateral that the user is using, the collateral token the user is using, together with the combinations of possible outcomes of possible events which are registered in this contract. And this position system is actually quite simple. There are very few operations that you can do on those. And just to explain them, so we have split, merge, and redeem position. So if you want to split a position, what you essentially do is you start with the collateral that you have, and then you can split it under a certain oracle condition, under a certain question, which has certain outcomes. And then if you split on the collateral, then you get basically for every possible outcome, you get one position which can be redeemed under the condition that this is representing the right outcome for the collateral again. And now you can do another split on this position using another question and add these also to this position. So basically, if you have yes, Elon Musk will step down, then you can split it on the condition that Tesla will be above or below, meaning that you create basically new two positions where yes, Elon Musk will step down under the condition Tesla stock will be above $300, and the additional position where Elon Musk will step down and Tesla stock will be below $300. The reason why you can do this is because they basically have the same meaning. Yeah. So if you have an asset which is true under both conditions, then you always know you can convert it back, merge it back to just this one single position. So yeah, we can do it also a bit more complex, but I think we'll skip this one. So redeeming positions. So let's assume you have those positions in this Elon Musk market. And now we know already Elon Musk was stepping down as a CEO. Then what we can resolve is, yeah, this market resolved to yes. And then if you have positions which include yes, then we can redeem them and basically remove this one condition from the position. And then if later at the end of the year we know Tesla stock was actually above $300, then we can redeem this position for US dollars or DAI or whatever we used. So yeah, this is a very simple system that allows us to create arbitrary combination of combinations of prediction market outcomes and remove this inefficiency that we otherwise had with what we created before, the nested outcome token sets. So this is all a bit abstract. Let's look in a concrete trade on such a market. So again, the same example. Let's say we actually want to invest 10 Ether to short Tesla under the condition that Elon Musk will step down. So we have two questions. Will Elon Musk step down? And the second question, will Tesla stock be above $300? And now, if we create all possible combinations of those, we'll see we have four, yeah, two to the power of two. And now, what we essentially do is, if we assume that we only invest under the condition that Elon Musk will step down, then we kind of have to hedge that Elon Musk will not step down, So all combinations here 3 and 4, where Q1, Elon Musk will step down, resolves to no, there we just keep 10 shares. So we know if Elon Musk will not step down, we can always get our initial investment back. And for the other possible outcome that Elon Musk actually will step down, there we are investing into, yeah, Tesla stock will not be above $300, and we are not buying any shares of the opposite outcome. So essentially, we make a profit in case Elon Musk steps down and Tesla stock drops, and we get a refund in case Elon Musk will actually not step down. So this is already implemented. It's one smart contract that allows you to basically define arbitrary positions in one identifier, which is used in this ERC-1155 contract. It has these very three simple functions to split, redeem, and merge positions, and also allows you to register any kind of oracle in the system. It's available on GitHub, all, of course, open source, so we are happy if you're taking a look at it and try it out. We also have implemented a concrete example. So here we have one experiment that we want to run on mainnet very, very soon. So we have three markets here. We have a market on the Ethereum difficulty. We have a market on the Ethereum block gas limit, and we have a market on the Ethereum US dollar price. And the assumption is that those markets correlate. Yeah? And now, because we have this new system, we can actually see how they eventually correlate by how people are trading on those markets. So in this case, we're using a concept called LMSR Market Maker. And those that are familiar with this concept, basically it's a smart contract that someone can fund. And then this smart contract allows anyone to trade against a smart contract. And for a simple prediction market, this market maker just allows to basically trade all possible outcomes of one prediction market. Now we modified this LMSR market maker in a way that it can trade arbitrary combinations of all kind of outcomes of those three markets. And now here we just set it up, and right now it starts with 50, 50, 50. And now we will buy 0.1 outcome tokens worth of Ether, and we invest into, yes, block difficulty will be higher than 3,000, and no, the block gas limit will be greater than 8,500,000. By the way, those numbers don't necessarily make sense. Like, the questions don't necessarily make much sense, but just to give you an idea. And so we apply this trade, and then we see that the market maker is changing the prices. So because we bought yes, the price or the probability of yes is increasing of the first market, and the probability of yes is decreasing on the second market. And now the interesting thing is that we can now do assumptions. So we were just doing this one trade. This is how the market looks like right now. And now we can make an assumption meaning that we want to invest into something, assuming that one of those markets has been resolved to one certain outcome. And now what we actually do is we assume here that the first market will resolve to yes. And then we see how this has an impact on the probability of the second market. So in this case, essentially it's moving from 40% to 34%. However, the third market is not changed at all, right? So the third market stays at 50%. And the reason why this is because the market, because of the first trade this was done, the first trader signaled that there is correlation between the first and the second market. Yeah? He made a statement that yes, difficulty will be higher. At the same time, he believes that the block gas limit will be not greater than X. And by doing this, he is feeding this information into the market. Yeah? And then if the next one is trading and he is making an assumption on the first or the second market, you will see how the probability of the first or second market is changing. The third market is not changed at all because no one has yet traded and there's no information in the market yet. So that's a new concept that we want everyone to try out. So we want to encourage everyone who has ideas about markets that correlate, that are interesting for the Ethereum community today, to suggest them to us. And we are happy to fund the most promising ones within our Gnosis ecosystem fund. And of course, it's important also that we have Oracle information. The markets that I just presented, the great the great property they have is that they can be resolved decentralized, because all information is on-chain, difficulty is on-chain, block hash limit is on-chain, the Ether price at least, we can already piggyback on Maker. So if you have examples for interesting prediction markets, conditional markets, which can leverage information which is already on the Ethereum blockchain, we are happy to listen to you and fund the best examples. Thank you very much. Yeah, I'm not sure. Do we have time for? Okay, cool.
I know if I understand correctly, but the functionality of the prediction market is now on the ERC specification. So all the Oracle stuff and all the Gnosis stuff is now on the ERC? Or is there other stuff in other contracts running going on?
So what I just presented is just one smart contract, which allows to register new oracles. And then based on those oracles, you can create arbitrary positions. Yeah, you can combine arbitrary oracle information, like let's say this. Yeah, we have those two oracles about Tesla. They have outcomes, and now you can basically arbitrarily combine those and invest in those. This is exactly what this framework does. So we defined also, we try to define oracle standard to allow, yeah, to allow basically to use all kind of oracle systems with this framework. We don't work on oracles. Not exactly sure if this was your question, but. Okay, then it was hard to understand.
To clarify, is that this is an ERC specification that is different from the rest in the sense that it is focused on one contract, while other ERC specifications are for a family of contracts, or it's not? I'm just lost here.
Yeah, so it is based on the ERC 1155 standard. It's not finalized yet, but what it essentially allows you to do is instead of creating new tokens, ERC 20 tokens, you have just one contract which can handle an arbitrary amount of tokens by just using, in addition, an identifier for a specific token. That's just a lot more gas efficient. So we were always arguing that for prediction markets, it doesn't necessarily make sense to just create new ERC-20 tokens for all possible outcomes, because you basically limit, just gas-wise, you limit prediction markets to very few outcomes right now by doing this. So you'll never see an Augur Gnosis prediction market with the old framework that has more than 8 outcomes, just because we cannot create more ERC-20 tokens. So it makes a lot more sense to try to find a way how you can represent all kind of outcomes with an identifier. And this is what this framework allows you to do. One more question. Okay.
Just a quick question. In a way, you are creating discrete investment depending on different arbitration tree. How do you know that the valuation of the different options is fair for the investors? I mean that some options are undervalued or other overvalued based on statistics.
It's a market. So if something is, if you believe something is overvalued or undervalued, you just have an incentive to participate to change the current market price. So we are not, this is how prediction market works, right? So you have people participating. And it's a market, so if someone believes that the market price is not representing the actual outcome, then they have an incentive to participate because they can make a profit. Right. I mean, like arbitration between different. I think we probably have to discuss it at our booth, but I will be at our booth right now after the talk. Thank you very much.